Thank you so much for joining us for CBN News Today. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Aaron. The United States is once again sending troops and warships to Iraq, a week after a radical Muslim group captured key cities across the country. The White House is deploying 275 soldiers to protect the U.S. Embassy, as well as a team of special forces. America is also considering an alliance with archenemy Iran in trying to quell the dangerous insurgency in Iraq.
Preparations to house thousands of fleeing Iraqis are underway at this makeshift camp inside Kurdistan.
This geographical area belongs to the Christians, Yazidis, and Kurds. We are happy that these people have come here. They're welcome. Everyone is.
Residents from Mosul and other parts of Iraq are beginning to arrive after the Al-Qaeda spinoff group known as the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria captured key cities across this country.
Everybody fled their homes. We were forced out of ours. We couldn't speak and left out of fear because there's death in Mosul.
President Obama told Congress Monday that 275 U.S. troops will be deployed to protect staff at the huge embassy in Baghdad. While their mission is non-combative, the Pentagon says U.S. soldiers are allowed to defend themselves if they are under attack. Some 170 of those soldiers are already on the ground. One senior U.S. official said up to 100 Special Forces soldiers could also join them. America has a number of military assets in the region, including four warships, a U.S. carrier able to launch 40 fighter jets, and two ships that can fire cruise missiles. Meanwhile, U.S. and Iranian officials are reportedly holding rare talks about how to stop the insurgents from gaining more ground in Iraq. A senior military commander of Iran's elite Quds force is in Baghdad this week.
I think we are open to any constructive process here that could minimize the violence, hold Iraq together, the integrity of the country, and eliminate the presence of outside terrorist forces that are ripping it apart.
Iraqi government forces are also engaged in the fight trying to slow the Islamist approach on the capital city. Today, they launched multiple strikes on terrorist positions some 40 miles from Baghdad.
The militant group ISIS has its sights set on Baghdad to the south. In the north sits the Kurdish enclave of Iraq, well protected by its own security forces. That's where many Christians and other refugees have fled for protection. CBN News correspondent Chris Mitchell reports from the Kurdish city of Erbil.
Thousands of Iraqi families have fled the fighting and come here to Erbil. They fled the bloodbath left in the wake of the ISIS lightning strike across northern and central Iraq. It's unlikely that ISIS will turn north because they'd face a formidable military foe in the Kurdish military. They call themselves the Peshmerga, which literally means those that face death. It's a key time for the region and especially here for the Kurdish people. They face a historic crossroads and the very real possibility they could declare themselves an independent state. But like the rest of Iraq, they face an uncertain future. With the U.S. seeking to disengage from the international arena and the rest of the international community unwilling to intervene, Iraq could face some of its most difficult days ahead. These are the lands of the Bible, the land of Nineveh and the prophet Jonah. And many here also believe this land has a future prophetic promise. In Isaiah 19, it says, "Assyria is the work of my hands." Because of the turmoil and fighting, Iraqi Christians are sending out an urgent prayer request to Christians around the world to pray that peace will come to these lands. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Erbil, in Kurdish Iraq.
Al-Shabab terrorists in Kenya killed 9 more people overnight. It happened in the same Kenyan coastal area where the Somali militant group slaughtered 48 people Sunday night. The Islamist group says the attack was in response to Kenya's brutal oppression of Muslims in Kenya. Witnesses say the gunmen singled out non-Muslims during the attack, going door to door, demanding to know if the men inside were Muslim and if they spoke Somali. Al-Shabab warned tourists to stay away from Kenya, saying that the once peaceful East Africa nation is now officially a war zone.
A huge Israeli search team spread out into the northern West Bank Monday, hoping to find 3 Israeli teenagers kidnapped by terrorists last week. One of the missing teens holds a dual U.S.-Israeli citizenship. In Nablus, the Israeli military uncovered a large weapons cache and arrested more than 40 Palestinians, many of them Hamas members. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said the operation to return the boys is complex and could take time. He called on other countries to condemn the abductions. The Palestinian Authority condemned the kidnappings Monday, but also condemned Israeli security measures.
Here at home, a 5-year-old child was killed after massive tornadoes swept through Nebraska Monday. At least 19 people were injured after twin tornadoes touched down roughly within a mile of each other. It happened about 100 miles northeast of Omaha in the town of Pilger. The twisters were reportedly to be deadly EF4s, generating winds of up to 200 miles per hour. One was estimated to have been nearly a mile wide. A county spokesman says half the tiny town was wiped out.
Everything lifted off of us, and the heater smashed over me and my buddy. We yelled at my buddy Donnie because me and my buddy Ethan were pinned in between the two bricks off the bottom of our basement. And we looked back at Donnie, and we thought he was gone for a long time. We kept yelling at him, and then we dug him out and pulled the wood off him, pulled the bricks off, and dug him out. And the three of us somehow were all fine. It killed my dog.
Dual tornadoes are rare enough, but the National Weather Service says it's very unusual for them to have funnel clouds roughly the same strength.
A West Virginia teenager used social media to save her father's life. When a storm knocked out phone service, she used her Facebook page to send out a plea for help. Our Caitlin Burke has this story.
It's a message that will break your heart.
My dad was dead. We need an ambulance, please.
With cell phone service out because of a storm, turning to Facebook was all 10-year-old Brianna could think to do.
The lightning crashed and hit a tree by our porch, and my dad's almost dead. We need an ambulance, please. Please call one for us if you have signal. We live in a yellow house.
Someone saw her emotional Facebook plea and called 911. Rescue crews quickly arrived at Brianna's home, saying her post helped save her father's life.
I was scared. I need help. My dad needs help, and there's nobody around, so I had to post that.
Brianna's dad was hospitalized with a few broken bones, but he's home now and was able to celebrate Father's Day with his quick-thinking daughter.
Just sit here in the house and be together and enjoy being with each other.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
President Obama is signing an executive order to expand gay rights, and it is unclear if there will be a religious exemption. The order bans federal contractors from discriminating against employees on the basis of their sexual orientation or gender identity. The Senate passed a broader measure that did include religious exemptions. Senator Orrin Hatch asked the White House to include those exemptions in its executive order. Religious leaders warn if there is no exemption, some Christian and Jewish charities may be forced to violate their faith or withdraw from federal contracts.
Churches that host high school graduation ceremonies will now have to hide their crosses and other religious symbols. A federal court in Chicago ruled in 2012 that displaying such symbols at public graduations violates the Constitution, even if the ceremony is held inside a church. Now the U.S. Supreme Court is refusing to weigh in on that ruling. Justices Scalia and Thomas said they were willing to hear the appeal, but 4 justices are needed to accept a case.
North Carolina legislators approved a bill that would clearly state how school students and staff can express religious beliefs. With a 48-1 approval in the Senate, the bill allows students to share religious views with reasonable restrictions. Students can pray to the same extent that they speak on non-religious matters. School staff may also, quote, adopt a respectful posture when students voluntarily lead prayer. The bill was prompted after a first grader was told to remove a reference to God in a Veterans Day observance poem. The bill is now headed to Governor Pat McCrory's desk for approval.
Coming up, have you ever wondered why some marriages succeed and others fail? We'll show you what happy couples have in common next.
Pat Boone here with a word about bank safety. Do you think your money is safe in the bank? Don't bank on it. A generation ago, bank accounts felt secure and they paid interest. This encouraged the virtue of thrift and saving. But today, Bank accounts pay virtually nothing, and they've shifted from low risk to high risk. For example, did you know your money deposited in most U.S. banks could be subject to limited withdrawal and even confiscation? Oh, yes. And that's just the first of 19 risks explained in a new white paper entitled, Don't Bank on It. You still think your bank deposits are safe? You better get this vital new Don't Bank on It white paper now. Call the number on the screen or visit SwissAmerica.com, the gold standard. Learn how simple it is to become your own banker today.
Millions of Americans with an ostomy live their lives to the fullest every day. And over the last 10 years, thousands have chosen Liberator Medical as their caring and reliable resource for ostomy supplies. Liberator Medical is a nationally accredited Medicare, Medicaid, and insurance provider, so we can handle all your Medicare, Medicaid, and insurance paperwork and billing. And Liberator Medical has been chosen as a preferred supplier by all the leading ostomy manufacturers, including Coloplast, Hollister, ConvaTec, and Generics. We supply all these leading ostomy brands so you can always get the ostomy supplies and accessories you want and trust. And all of our ostomy care specialists are product certified by the manufacturers. Shipping is free and discreetly delivered right to your door. Unhappy with your present ostomy supplier? Call Liberator Medical and ask about our free ostomy sampling program. We also offer catheters and urological supplies. Call 1-800-513-3076. That's 1-800-513-3076.
In Alaska, free pregnancy tests will soon be available in restaurant and bar bathrooms. The Anchorage Daily News reports it's part of a new campaign by the University of Alaska to prevent pregnant women from drinking. Alaska has the highest rate of fetal alcohol syndrome in the country. And Alaskan women of childbearing age are 20% more likely to binge drink than the national average. The $400,000 program starts this December and will span over 2 years.
Many couples choose to live together instead of getting married because they're not sure they will stay happy in the long run. But as Paul Strand reports, staying in love for a lifetime isn't as hard as you might think.
These days, marriage gets a bad rap. More and more attention is paid to divorce statistics, and you rarely see or hear about any couples living their dream for a lifetime.
The cliche is that in American suburbs like these, people are leading lives of quiet desperation. But the fact is, many are not desperate at all. And they're living in really happy marriages that will last a lifetime. Now there's a book that shares the secrets of how they stay highly happy and married forever.
Before we got married,
Atlanta's Shanti Feldhahn and her husband Jeff have already written relationship bestsellers like For Women Only and For Men Only. Now this Harvard-trained researcher has gathered comprehensive data and research about really satisfied husbands and wives. What she found? Happy couples share a few key attitudes and actions. She puts all this in The Surprising Secrets of Highly Happy Marriages and teaches that anyone can learn them. The first of these happy habits? Believe the best of your spouse, no matter what happens. Choosing to believe they care for you turns almost any situation positive. Jeff learned this from his own experience.
I knew that I could trust her. I knew that she had my best interest. I knew that she loved me, and I would believe the best.
The happiest couples go, okay, they couldn't have meant it, they love me, and let's move on. It makes a huge difference when you assume the best.
Shanti's research includes Kim and Sabrina Moore. They personify another of those traits that bring long-term joy. They went all in. There's no escape route or any thought of the D word, divorce. They don't keep secret cash accounts in case the relationship crumbles. And Kim describes the results of not going all in.
Death, because it creates a wedge. And God has designed it for it to be complete intimacy. And you can't have intimacy if you have hidden pockets, you know, things you're holding and hiding from each other.
Sabrina credits going all in for their 27-year union.
I believe that we are happier now than we've ever been.
And don't forget the little things. Thank your husband. Let him know you appreciate his efforts.
Saying it to a guy, that is his equivalent of I love you.
Men need to take their wife's hand, leave her thoughtful messages, and not be afraid of public displays of affection, like putting an arm around her.
All of those things convey that I'm choosing you all over again.
And men need to learn how to quickly get out of a bad mood.
So when he makes the effort to pull himself out of the funk and to not be grumpy, to not be morose, it's like, whew, this isn't going to go in this bad direction.
Another action of the highly happy, no unrealistic expectations. That's because if your spouse can't realistically meet your expectations, then you can't ever really be happy with them. Sabrina came into marriage with this problem.
There were expectations from her towards me that I had no idea that were there. So there was resentment that began to build up because she said, he should know this, and I didn't.
And there would be this wedge and this wall between us that he couldn't comprehend. And I couldn't comprehend that he couldn't comprehend, so.
Your expectations have to change coming into this thing.
Shanti says the research proves without a doubt the homes that practice the habits and attitudes highlighted in her book will be joy-filled. Struggling couples can use them to turn their marriages around. And the Feldhahns want people to know this truth, that the 50% divorce rate is a myth. About 80% thrive and survive, not a measly half.
If you know, most marriages do make it. Most marriages are happy. It's a completely different feeling. Like, you know what? Statistically, we're going to be just fine. We can get through this because most people do.
So the facts show, the reality is you have no reason to be fatalistic. Every couple has it in their power to make their marriage one that can truly be called highly happy. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Atlanta, Georgia.
Up next, a healthy eating plan that's so easy a caveman could do it. Get the secret behind the paleo diet next.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Obese children are at risk of diseases like diabetes and high blood pressure. In the past, those diseases were considered a threat mainly to adults. But the Times of India reports a new study from University of Children's Hospital in Leipzig, Germany. It found that kids as young as 6 develop more and bigger fat cells. That leads to increased inflammation and other problems. So young children may be facing diseases from an early age that could cripple their lives.
Inflammation is one of the most serious health problems in America. If you can't feel it, and you won't even know that it's there until it becomes a problem.
And doctors believe inflammation could be behind heart disease, arthritis, cancer, and dozens of other diseases, but you can fight it. And as Lori Johnson tells us, you might lose some weight while you're doing it.
Mark Sisson is the picture of health. At the age of 60, yes, 60, he has the body of a man half his age, inside and out. No disease, no medications. But he hasn't always been this way. His anti-inflammatory diet changed everything.
Most of what ails people today could be, if not cured, substantially mitigated with a few lifestyle corrections, first and foremost being diet.
Mark follows the paleo diet.
If you've heard of the paleo diet but aren't really sure what it is, you're not alone. It was the number one search diet on Google last year.
For the last 25 years, Mark has analyzed nutrition research. 2.5 million readers follow Mark's work.
We've got hundreds of thousands of user experiences on my site, on Mark's Daily Apple, of people who've embraced this program, who've said, so not only did I lose the weight, but my blood work improved. And my energy levels improved.
The paleo diet involves avoiding sugar, wheat, trans or omega-6 fats, and some dairy.
When you get rid of all those bad guys, you decrease inflammation and you improve your body's ability to burn fat.
Sugar weakens your immune system and causes insulin problems. Wheat treats your body much the same way. Mark didn't even realize wheat caused him problems until he stopped eating it.
My IBS went away, my arthritis went away, the lingering sinus issues that I had went away, the heartburn that I used to have infrequently, but enough to be, to have me carrying Pepcid AC in my wallet, that went away.
Highly inflammatory trans fats and omega-6 fats are found in many packaged foods and oils that line the grocery store shelves.
And we eliminate these industrial oils, what we call these the vegetable oils that we thought 2 decades ago were so healthy for us. Turns out they're very unhealthy for us.
Many dairy products cause inflammation, allergies, and stomach problems.
So if you give up sugar, gluten, trans fats, omega-6 fats, and dairy, you may be wondering what's left to eat.
Turns out, a lot.
Certainly use plants, vegetables, as the main basis of the paleo eating strategy, and then great sources of protein, so meat and fish, fowl, eggs, and so on, and then healthy fats.
Healthy fats include avocados, nuts, olive oil, fish oil, and don't forget coconut oil, even though it's a saturated fat. In fact, some health experts don't believe saturated fats like beef, pork, and eggs should still be viewed as bad guys when it comes to our diet.
Some doctors have still have a real issue with saturated fat because they're relying on a 20-year-old studies that were faulty to begin with, and they haven't done the research, and they haven't stayed current with dietary research. But there are thousands of doctors now who have completely shifted and are embracing this concept.
That includes Duke University's Dr. Eric Westman, who used to think saturated fat caused heart disease. Then he changed his mind.
Saturated fat, the fat that we've been taught not to eat, raises your good cholesterol best of all the food you can eat.
Of course, any diet is best combined with exercise. Looking at Mark, you might think he lives at the gym, but the truth is he barely breaks a sweat. He recommends slow movement, like walking, and a lot of it, outside or even at a treadmill desk. Twice a week, he recommends muscle building. Using his own weight as resistance, Mark does push-ups, squats, lunges, and sit-ups.
The tension of the muscle on the bone, it creates bone density, for instance. And we want to have strong bones as we get older.
Then once a week, a set of sprints, giving all you've got for 30-second surges of aerobic activity, like running, biking, or swimming.
That little burst of activity can have such dramatic effects on all aspects of your health. And for people who have been trying to lose weight, for instance, and are plateaued or stalled, that sprint workout can be sort of the breakthrough.
Finally, get enough sleep, because without it, your immune system suffers and you increase hormones that make you hungry.
A lot of people will get the diet right, for instance. They'll start to dial in the diet, but because they enjoy they're too tempted by the nighttime activities and they don't get enough sleep, they wonder why they're not losing that last 15 or 20 pounds. It may be because you're not getting enough sleep.
So an anti-inflammatory diet is missing sugar, wheat, processed oils, and most dairy. So you eat foods that keep you thin and healthy well into your golden years. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
Do you have an idea for a new product or invention? Hi, I'm George Foreman. People ask me all the time, George, how do I get my idea in front of companies? How do I get a patent? What do I do next? Do you have the same questions? I'll tell you like I'll tell them all. Call my friends at InventHelp.
InventHelp has been helping inventors for more than 30 years and has sales offices nationwide. InventHelp can provide patent referrals and submit your invention to companies who are interested in receiving new ideas. If you have an idea and want to try to patent it and submit it to companies, you should call InventHelp today for free information.
Listen, I can't guarantee your company will be interested in your idea, but I believe every inventor deserves the opportunity to step into the ring and take their best shot. Put InventHelp in your corner.
For your free inventors information, call 1-800-461-9290. That's 1-800-461-9290.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no-obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids. Do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah! Well, do you? Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
Finally today, victory for Team USA at the World Cup.
That's right. The men's U.S. soccer team beat their nemesis Ghana 2-1 in a nail-biting match that wasn't decided until the final minutes. It started with a stunning goal from American Clint Dempsey in the first 30 seconds of the game, earning him the fifth quickest goal in World Cup history. Ghana tied up the score late in the second half, but with the game wrapping up, substitute John Brooks headed in the winning goal off a corner kick. Across the U.S., soccer fans erupted in jubilation. Massive viewing parties were held from California to Missouri to South Dakota. The victory was especially sweet for Team USA because Ghana had knocked the U.S. out of the World Cup in 2010 and 2006. The U.S. plays Portugal next on Sunday.
USA. Got it. Good job.
Kudos. Well, that's going to do it for now on CBN News Today. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of issues you care most about at cbnnews.com.
Thank you so much for joining us. Make it a terrific Tuesday, everybody.